Good evening, dear friends. Here is Earth Major speaking. For 2-3 weeks I have not done a video anymore because I was a little tired to make all these videos. I'm a little busy also with the translation of my English book in Italian. Yes, it is weird. I wrote an English book with an help translator, but not in Italian. So now I have to translate it in Italian. The title is The Real Measures of the Flat Earth. So I will begin now a series of short video, 1 minute, 3 minutes, 5 minutes maximum, because I want to make more available the material to all people that have no time. And today it is more and more difficult to have time to share important material to all people. So this is the reason why I will try to make shorter videos. So let's start with Coriolis acceleration. This is a phenomenon that occurs when a body is moving in a rectilinear direction over a rotating platform. This happens, for example, over the globe, because the globe is not a platform, but it is rotating about its axis. So a body that is moving in the north-south direction from the North Pole to the equator, to the equator from the to the South Pole, and so on, subject to the Coriolis acceleration, because it is departing from the axis of the Earth. So the peripheral speed of the Earth will change, and when a speed changes, we have acceleration. And this acceleration acts over a mass with a force. So we have the Coriolis force that we should feel if we want to move exactly in the south, in an exclusively southern direction, we should feel a force, or we should impose a force over our car, for example, to be sure that we are driving exactly in the south direction. Let's think to an helicopter that it is on the ground on the North Pole. It takes off. So when it takes off, it is on the air, it doesn't feel anymore the drag of the Earth. So when it starts to move toward the equator, it should see under itself the Earth moving at a speed that increases with time from 0 to 1,700 kilometers per hour, that is the speed, the peripheral speed of the equator. But this doesn't happen. You can ask to all pilots, to if you know someone that that fly an helicopter, but it is something that doesn't happen. If an helicopter moves in the southern or in the northern direction, it will not see the Earth moving under itself. Okay, there is an objection. Many people make the objection that it is the air, the atmosphere, that pushes the helicopter, because the atmosphere moves with the Earth. With the next video, we are doing short videos now, with the next video we will go, we will give an answer to this objection, to understand why an helicopter doesn't feel the Coriolis force. It seems quite clear that Coriolis doesn't act, doesn't manifest over the Earth, because the Earth, we say, it is motionless. It is flat and motionless. So Coriolis is a clear proof of the fact. Coriolis not manifesting over the Earth, it is a clear proof of the fact that the Earth is motionless. Okay, thank you very much for following me. Bye-bye.